So in the UK, we have an examination system where it's called A-levels effectively. So it's the last 2 years of your schooling where you will sit for, well, largely most people will do four exams. So you do three or four subjects. Most of your university offers will require three subjects, and you'll be graded on, and you're assessed on those subjects, and however well you do will open doors to certain universities depending on their requirements.
Can I just pop in? No, I was just going to say, for anyone who's doing, because we have quite a few people who aren't in the English system, so crucially they're kind of national board exams, basically. So, you know, Anthony would sit the same maths exam as me if we're doing the same board, even though we were at different schools. And then, yeah, based on those grades, whether you get the grades or not. So when you get into a UK university, you're given an offer. So it's conditional, your acceptance is conditional on that you achieving certain grades, basically. Interrupt Anthony, yeah, carry on.
It's good to clarify that because in this country, considering that we have several different boards, it makes it quite difficult sometimes to compare. Think universities today have a fairly good grasp of where different boards are at in terms of their their examinations. About my A-levels, my A-levels, I'm very scientific. I like to I love sciences, I love maths, so my A-levels were biology, chemistry, physics and maths. And I at first was considering a career in medicine. That was always the dream from a very young age, and going through my schooling, through GCSEs, through sixth form, I had always this idea that, you know, I was going to be a doctor. That was it. It was always the plan. So I was one of few people in my school to maintain doing four A-levels instead of three. And I did that for the purposes of keeping my options open, because although it was a dream for many years, towards the latter part of my schooling, I was starting to get the itch for maybe something other than medicine, and questioning whether it was my vocation or not. I kept the option open.
How did you come to change your mind? Was it kind of work experience, or kind of what was the final straw? Because I remember you did the UK CAT exams and everything, didn't you? You were geared up for medicine.
I did very, very well in the UK CAT. I was very chuffed with my score. I got 890 in the maths section, which was unreal. So I was really, really happy there. But I think it's a combination of factors. I had an amazing physics teacher through my
Really helps, doesn't it?
Unbelievable. Yeah. When you have a good mentor and you can, when they really just spark a passion in you, I think that was a real big boost for me, and in knowing what I wanted to pursue.